weight. Then I coveted them and took them, and beheld, they are hid in the earth in the midst of thy tent, and the silver under it. So Joshua sent messengers, and they ran unto the tent, and beheld it was hid in the tent, and the silver under it. And they took them out of the midst of the tent, and brought them unto Joshua, and of the children of Israel, and laid them out before the Lord. And Joshua and all Israel with him took Achan the son of Zerah, and the silver, and the garment, and the wedge of the gold, and his sons, and his daughters, and his oxen, and his asses, and his sheep, and his tent, and all that he had. And they brought them into the valley of Achor. And Joshua said, Why hast thou troubled us? The Lord shall trouble thee this day. And all Israel stoned him with stones and buried them with fire after they had stoned them with stones. Yes.
Yes. See, Achan thought it was covered up, that God wouldn't know and Joshua wouldn't find out. But he learned the hard way. Achan coveted something.
Jesus.
He looked upon the spoils and the money and had greed in his heart.
Yes.
And that's when sin took come in.
My.
Not when he took it, but when he looked upon his covenant.
That's right.
And because of that, God's not going to have sin in his church, in his camp, in anything.
That's right.
And it's only punishable by death. I know, church, it's a slow one tonight.
Come on, Bubba, that's okay.
It's more reading than it's preaching.
That's okay, yeah, Bubba.
Come on, son. That's right.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, help us tonight, God. Thank you, Father. Well, I lost a message, my text here. Anyway, you read on 1 Samuel. It shows how Saul kills himself. Philistines was against him. He had nowhere to turn. And he knew the end was up. He took his sword and shoved it in his chest, committed suicide, and died. Now, church, like I said, God knows everything and he sees all. You can't hide nothing from him. Trust me, I've tried. It's not possible.
Yes, come on.
We've all seen him come up short of repentance.
That's right.
That's right.
Now,
yes, Lord.
The thing is, Achan and Saul never had a chance to learn from him. God gave them chance and chance after chance.
Yes.
But they turned away to do what they wanted to do.
That's right.
Now, church, we have our own free will. God's going to let you do whatever you want for however long you want to do it.
That's right.
Yes, he is.
Preach to me.
I don't know how to put this, but I have somebody very dear in my life.
Come on, Bubba.
The road will run out. The fun's going to stop. The joy's going to go away.
Yes, it will.
The time is going to come to an end. The toy house that she's built, that she's played in, will be crushed. And God let me know this in his message. But he also let me know this. We're not exempt, church.
That's right. That's right.
We're not better.
No, we're not.
That's right.
We're not more holy.
Nope.
We're not more perfect.
That's right. Come on.
We're not more righteous. Because we all can fall with the same thing.
That's right.
Amen.
But I come to tell you because it's easy.
Yes.
It's the small foxes that swore the violent.
That's right.
That's right.
Because the devil's conniving.
Yes.
He's controlling.
Yes. Yes.
And he's patient.
Yes.
Just like Adam and Eve in the garden. She talked to Eve. The devil did.
Mm.
In a seductive way.
Mm-hmm.
Not sexually.
Come on, Bob.
But mentally.
Yes.
And beguiled her.
Yes.
To do what he wanted her to do.
Yes.
just like Samuel. Them spirits fell upon him, and he started giving in to them. Now God placed David there for a reason to play the harp, but he got tired of it. He gave in to it because he heard in the city that David kills his 10,000 and Saul his thousands.
Jesus.
And he thought David was better than him and became wroth in his soul. Like I told you about Achan, he didn't sin when he took it.
That's right.
He sinned when it was in his heart. We looked upon it. And just like Achan, from that very point on, it was over. Samuel, it was over the very moment he gave in to those things, those spirits. And I know, church, it may not seem like much. It wasn't a shower. But it got me. It got me to thinking.
Yes.
As I hope every message will.
Yes.
He was a king. Samuel was. I mean, Saul was. But he failed the same way we can. And I pray tonight, church, that we don't get to that point. We don't get to that place. Because it's a very scary thing to fall in the hands of an Almighty God. That's wroth and angry. Because he is a God of love, but he's also a God of wrath and judgment. Because I would hate for the rock to fall on me and ground me to powder. I'd rather fall on the rock and it break me.
Yes,
my pieces can be repaired. And church, these altars are open.
My Lord.
Pray as you think. You should pray. But I'm going to tell you, ask God to lead you and guide you, because it's not a game. People think it is. People think it's going to be okay. I'll get saved one day.
Jesus.
That day may never come.
Right.
I'll get rid of these things in my heart one day. But that day doesn't come.
Mm-mm.
In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, this world could be over. Your life as you know it could come to an end. But I pray this gets you curious. This gets you thinking. God, what's in my heart?
Right.
Check me.
Yes, amen.
Because if a king over a country could fall,
that
had the ear of God, that heard God, that knows God, that God walked with him and talked with him and directed him, how easy could it be for me?
Amen.
That's right.
Now, I have somebody that I love with all my heart out there that felt the things I feel, knows the things I know, and been in places God I've never been.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
But woe unto thee, those that know and don't obey.
Right.
Because you know the right way, but you deliberately say no.
That's right.
You push it off. And you push it off. And me and Dad was talking the other day. God will let you have what you want for a little while, because he knows it's not what you really want. Because eventually you're going to come running back to him with open arms.
That's right.
Lord, I need you.
Yes, yes.
But he does it to correct us. Just like that man at work. He was made for that time because that moment came to him where it was decision time. Where God drew the line. There was no more backing out, no more running away. This was it. Either you obey me now, or you die here. And hell will be your home. And church, I don't want to get to that place. And I pray every day that I don't get big headed. I don't look down on those. I stay humble. I stay meek.
Yes, amen.
Because it's the heart that God looks at. Not the color, not the way you talk or act. But it's the heart. And that's the very thing the devil tries to get to, because if he knows he can destroy your heart, he's got you where he wants you.
Yes.
You'll play around for a little while. You'll have your fun for a season. But when he's done with you, he tosses you to sigh like a dirty rag. He never knew you. Because that's how it works. He sucks the life out of you that he wants to suck out. And he's done. Church, these altars are open. I pray we don't get to that place. I pray that we We stay knowledgeable. Be a lamp unto our feet, light under our path. And we follow you.